Hello, my friends. I'm Luca Turilli, guitar player of Rhapsody of Fire, and you are enjoying the Metal Cast. Ciao, see you soon.
Hello, Luca.
Hi,
is that you?
Polina?
Hi. Yes.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. How are you?
I was thinking that through Skype was not possible to speak because before the line fades, so I thought, oh my god, with Skype, I don't know if this stuff works.
Yeah, it just my computer froze a little bit. It's all the effect of your album, you know, everything freezes around.
Super.
Okay, so glad to see you. No, sorry, to hear you. Yeah, so first of all, congratulations on such a great comeback.
Thank you so much. But, you know, after 4 years, it was the minimum not to come out with a decent release. At least I hope. But it seems like this because the people seem to like. We are in the charts in many, many countries. Actually, it's the top record for to be in so many countries now at the same time. So it's very, very, very good. We are very, very happy.
Okay, and how does it feel in general to be back in action?
Well, you know, when for artists that are also very creative, like me, for example, it's very difficult, you know, to stay 4 years without having the possibility to release something. And so, I mean, in the end, when you have finally, after all this pressure, no, you have finally the possibility to release something, now we are really 100% energy, totally motivated, because, of course, for an artist, the best thing is to express himself, no, through what he's doing, in our case, the music. So, I mean, it's very important, no, to let speak your soul.
Yeah. How did you manage to keep the spirit within the band during all these years of absence?
But we didn't see each other, so it was better like this, probably. No, otherwise we would have fought. No, in the sense that absolutely no problem, you know, for the spirit, because, I mean, when we had there was the time for the composition, thanks to it, first, to such composition, we isolate ourselves completely, no, from the problem, legal problems, whatever problem you can have in your life. So the composition is really like to go in a parallel dimension, no? And for days, months, you really live in another world. So the spirit is always there, it's not something that goes or comes dependently from the problems of the daily life, no? It's really another world, so this is something that is always there, protected, and so we didn't feel so much the bad influences of our problems, let's say.
Okay. How long has it been since you started drafting the ideas for the album and finished the recording?
Ah, okay. This was a particular thing really related to this new album, because it was the first time that we started composing the songs really from zero, no? Because usually, you know, after each production, you have some songs that are left, or some parts of songs that you can still keep, modify for a new release, no? This happens to many bands, no? But in this case, for the fact to have so much time, after 2 years, knowing that the new album would have seen the light and be released really in a long time, we had the chance to listen to our old songs, and we decided that they were not really what we wanted for the new release. So we decided really to throw them in the garbage. And we started composing everything from zero. And this was happening 2 years ago. So I can say that we composed the new songs for the new album in 1 year, and 1 year before entering the studio. And we entered the studio in September of the last year, that was 2009.
Okay, I see. But what happens to those songs? Have you, like, completely threw them away, or...
Yes, you know, after... So, this is not something special for us, no? In the sense that after every album there are, I don't know, 4 or 5 titles that are thrown anyway in the garbage. So, it's normal for us, because many times, I don't know, we create something, then we have our demo, our private demo, no, for us to check the songs before mm-hmm. entering the studio, it is. And many times, especially me, I'm this kind of guy that listen is very critic, no, with himself, like this. It doesn't happen many times that I call Alex, I tell him, and he doesn't like this, of course, at all. I think we have to open back the computer because this refrain of this song is really shit, no? So I'm not happy 100% with it. And so we started working again, and then other days so we have to meet and so on. So it's a... Every album, behind every album of Rhapsody, there is this kind of selection, natural selection for each song, I would say.
Okay. Would you ever like to share those other songs that were somehow composed and then discarded? Would you ever like to share them with the fans through some releases?
No. Because when a song is not accepted, I don't want that this is spread, no?
Okay.
No. What is not selected in the end is better to throw away. Because even if some other people could like, the fact that we don't like is not acceptable. It's strange, no, artistically, from an artistical point of view.
I see. Okay. Also, in November of 2008, you made an announcement about your new Dragon Flame studio. Right?
Yeah.
And then you still recorded in Sasha's Gate studio.
No, but you know, this is very particular because this studio is to compose the music and now from the next album I will record the guitars and the voice of Fabio.
Okay.
So, yes, we make step by step. And now, for example, in this album we recorded in Germany, but I and Alex produced the album and Sasha mixed it. Also, apart for the fact that he was totally busy when we were there in Germany while he was mixing the album for Avantasia, no?
Yeah.
So he was, you know, to be a Summit
of
album,
course.
No? So he was very busy with that stuff. And so I saw Sasha personally just 2 times, no?
Mm-hmm.
And so it was a very particular this production. But anyway, doesn't matter because I and Alex already we were co-producer in the last 2-3 albums, also me with my solos, and we now feel that we are at the point that we really can produce by ourselves the album because we know perfectly after so many years of experience what we want in our album from 0 to 100, no?
Okay.
So I mean, we don't need a really external help, and then we have also to say that this is not really Sasha's favorite music, but at the same time we would never renounce to him when you have to speak about the mix, no?
Uh-huh.
Because the mix for a band like Rhapsody is fundamental, important, and I and Alex, honestly, we are not in the possibility to mix one of our albums, no? And you need really a special person, and that is what Sasha is, a really special person that knows the expert, and he could mix from pop to extreme metal. So, and then the fact that there is this difficulty in our mixes, that you have also the symphonic elements, not only the metal band, this makes even the things more difficult. You really need a person able to know all about frequencies, to divide well the frequencies between strings of the orchestra, or even if you don't have the orchestra, from the orchestral samples, no?
Okay.
And the guitars, all these, usually they always feel the place to each other with the frequencies, no? So really you need a super person working behind the console, and we found Sasha. This was a divine gift, I would say.